Folks, I'm David Bassler. Welcome to this sales training on building relationships. Today, we are going to be discussing talking on the phone versus texts or email. As we have discussed before, there are many important traits that most successful salespeople share. Things like being upbeat and confident, passionate, creative, goal-oriented, or even accountable. But one of the most important traits they have is they are powerfully effective at building relationships. When you can do this with a buyer, that buyer is buying from a friend rather than a stranger. Who would you rather buy from? Now, to be good at building relationships, you not only have to sincerely like people, you have to be willing to listen to them, to be sympathetic to their problems and difficulties and challenges. This is where you have an opportunity to come in with a solution to help alleviate their load. You won't always be able to build relationships with someone in person, especially if you have a role in inside sales, for example. In inside sales in particular, but also in outside sales, you have to be good at building relationships over the phone. Now, as every sales manager knows, getting salespeople to pick up the phone versus using text or email has been getting harder and harder in recent years, particularly as millennials have entered the workforce. Why is this? Well, there's a variety of reasons, but in survey after survey, the number one reason given is it's too time consuming. Because a phone conversation requires the niceties of, well, conversation. How are you doing? How's your family? How's your weekend? How's your business? All this takes time, and wrapping up the conversation takes time also. For millennials in particular, they are the last generation born before the advent of the internet. They have grown up in front of screens, and all the electronic communications they receive no doubt feel like a sort of imposition. Impositions that do have the advantage of, as in the email example, providing a buffer before a response is required. With conversation, no such buffer exists. You have to think quickly and use all of your social skills in the moment for a phone conversation to go well. But as we have mentioned, these conversations can be critical to building a relationship, which is, once again, an attribute of a successful salesperson. So perhaps the best thing we can do is to think of some of the positive advantages of having a phone conversation. So I'm going to share my whiteboard with you. First advantage, a phone conversation helps improve our social and communication skills. If you can talk well on the phone, chances are you can talk well in person. Number two, texted or emailed messages can be hard to interpret. What does that emoji mean anyway? With a conversation, you can be completely direct. You can hear tone, you can sense mood, etc. Number three, when you make the effort to make a phone call, people take you more seriously. The effort counts. Number four, you will make less mistakes in conveying your message, i.e., people are less likely to misunderstand you with a phone call. Number five, a phone conversation forces you to give the other person your undivided attention. People love having someone's undivided attention, and they will like you more for it. Number six, writing or texting long messages is exhausting. You will save considerable energy by simply picking up the phone and talking to someone. Number seven, a text or email is very impersonal. A phone conversation gives you a greater chance to connect on a personal level. Plus, people love hearing another human voice, their laughter, their thoughts. It makes you more human, but more importantly, as concerned sales, it makes you more likely to be liked. Now let's review again. Number one, a phone conversation helps you improve your social skills. Number two, texted or email messages can be hard to interpret. Number three, people will take you more seriously if you call them. Number four, you will make less mistakes in conveying your message if you call someone. Number five, a phone conversation forces you to give the other person your undivided attention, and people like this. Number six, writing or texting long messages is exhausting. You will save considerable energy simply by picking up the phone. And number seven, a text or email is very impersonal. People love having conversations and getting to talk to another human being and laughing and sharing their thoughts. It makes you more human, and it makes you more likely, if you have a good conversation, it makes you more likely to be liked. Even though it can be hard to do, especially if you are used to texting or emailing all the time, try picking up the phone and calling someone. They just may love you for it. Thanks for watching and happy selling.
Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to Easy Peasy for more videos and please share. We love you, Easy Peasy.